La coqueta, la coqueta, you know who I am. FIFA 20 defending, I feel like Uncle Sam. Texting all you haters cause you ain't I defend. Call the apps Tekashi cause all they do is bend. Broke boy, elite is what I like to choke boy. I am just a joke boy. Persecutes me, nom nom nom, I'm bok choy. Yeah, yeah, I'm a broke boy. Leave you swimming with the fishes, I am so coy. Opposition looking funny, joke coy. Class session, yeah, take some notes, boy. Broke boy.
What is going on, YouTube? It is your boy, One Star Weekly, and we are back for yet another episode of the Broke Boy Road to Glory. And there's actually not much catching up to do today. Normally, I do some SBCs. Normally, I open some packs, stuff like that. But today or overnight, I didn't really get a chance to do many SBCs. EA really hasn't dropped anything too interesting. But I will say that this SBC that they did drop today for Weston McKennie looks like a beast. And from what I'm hearing online, they misadvertised the card on Twitter. So on Twitter, I think the card is 93 physical instead of 91 and 89 defense instead of 87. And if they're forced to then upgrade the stats of this card, then I think it's going to be actually a beast of a card. And we look at the card. It actually looks like an insane, insane card. He looks like a cheap Vieira. I mean, all the stats are really there. Even the shooting stats are not that bad. And he does have a strong link into that other FFS Turkish center back. So I don't know. I'm kind of tempted to do him, but I do think the SBC overall might be a trap. It might be a coin sink. Stuff like that. Another update I have for you guys is in squad battles. I am currently Elite 2. And yeah, I'm knocking on the door of Elite 1. I think I'm going to grind to hit Elite 1 before the thing expires so I can get those two rare mega packs to 30k packs. And who knows, maybe I end up packing a Joao Felix. Maybe I end up packing something that's going to change the account. I don't know. But we're here to talk about one man and one man only. As you know from the thumbnail, as you know from the title, we're going to be talking about this 88 right guard card. And when you look at the card, he looks like a very meta center back. He doesn't really look spectacular, but he looks like he has stats in all the right places. He's 6'2". He has medium work rates. He's right-footed with a 4-star weak foot, 3-star skill moves. I have now played 22 games with him, all of them in the weekend league, and I have 0 goals, 1 assist. Before we go any further, though, if you're enjoying the content, if you're liking what you're seeing so far, please don't hesitate to hit the like button down below. And if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing to the channel. I appreciate all you guys at home for watching this video. So, when you look at this right card card, I mean, what does he bring to your team? What are his weaknesses? So off first glance, he looks like a well-rounded card. He looks like a card you can even bring in to the midfield, play him at CDM. So when you look at his pace, it's very good, 78 pace. With the new patch really boosting the defender's pace, I think 78 pace is gonna be quite good. His passing stats are very nice. So if you want a ball playing center back, that looks like a very nice thing to have. His dribbling stats are very nice as well, but they are concerning if you want to play him in the midfield because the 73 agility, 58 balance may let you down in more advanced positions. However, as a center back, it's quite good. His defending stats are very well rounded. He has no major weakness here, and his physical stats are very nice as well. The only thing I was concerned about was his aggression at 77. So I went ahead and threw an anchor chem style on him. It'll give him a little more pace, a little more defending, and the much needed boost to the aggression. Before we go into the gameplay though, I'm gonna show you guys some of my records. So we have Keane on 20 games, 12 goals, 7 assists. Not too bad of a contribution. He is starting to let me down in the tight games where I need a better weak foot, where I need some slightly better dribbling, but overall, he's actually pretty usable even in the higher echelons of weekend league. We got George Best, who's actually one of my favorite players on this team. As you can see here, the stats are not that good, but I'm playing him as a wide cam, and he's fulfilling that role quite well. I think the star of the team has to be Mbappe. You guys at home kept on telling me last week, get Mbappe, get Mbappe, get Mbappe. We got Mbappe, and he is not disappointing. 14 goals, 7 assists as a cam is very, very good. And Awar as a CDM, I was questionable whether he was worth it in the weekend league. I think he's doing quite a good job. But yeah, without further ado, we're going to jump into the gameplay. I'm going to give you guys a weekend league update, and I'm going to let you guys know, is this right card worth it? Let's go. All right, so according to Footbin, this card is going to fluctuate between 500 to 525,000 coins to purchase on the PS4 market. Is he worth that money? I would have to say he's actually a decent value. I would have to rate his value as a 5 out of 10 because there are better center backs you can get for cheaper, or maybe similar center backs you can get for cheaper. But as far as icons go, I think he may be the best at this price range. We're going to break down the stats though so you know exactly what to expect at home. So, how's his pace feeling game? And like I said, with the pace boost to defenders, I do think the 78 pace is quite adequate. He's not the quickest defender, but at the same time, when I got caught on counters, when I had to chase down an Mbappe, an Orsic, any card like that, he had no issues and he would catch up, especially with his long legs, in really decent time. I never really got caught out with him, and I don't play drop back. I play with 4 depth on balance, so I do think his pace is good enough to play at the higher levels. I gotta give his pace an 8 out of 10. Next, we're going to talk about his passing. And one of the things that really attracted me to this card was his ball playing and passing ability. How does it feel in game? And honestly, he feels very composed playing out of the back. And having him with Luis alongside him, it's really a treat to have. I really enjoy playing possession. Sometimes if I have to, I pass all the way back to my center backs to regroup, to reset. And this right guard card is very nice at that. His vision at 80, his short passing at 87, his long passing at 84 make him a very well-rounded ball-playing center back. And I was even able to ping long threaded through balls from the back and really set up some of my wide cams to really get him behind the defense. I really enjoyed this aspect of the card. I gotta give his passing an 8.5 out of 10. Next, we are gonna cover his dribbling because, like I said, he was on paper a very good ball-playing center back. How do you feel in game? And honestly, his agility felt better than the stats indicate in game. And I never applied an engine, a guardian, anything like that to him. I left it as is. The first chem style I tried on him was a catalyst, and then I went on and placed an anchor chem style on him. And in game, his dribbling was very nice. He felt decently light for somebody who was stocky in game. He was able to dribble around the back. He was even able to dribble out of pressure. He's a very press-resistant center back if that's what you want. His ball control at 89, his dribbling at 72 does mean that if he is going in for a challenge, he most likely will keep possession of the ball. His 90 composure, of course, is going to help him in all aspects of his game. He feels very composed playing out of the back. He feels very composed in tight scenarios. And overall, I got to give his dribbling an 8.5 out of 10. As a center back, it's such a nice thing to have. Next, we are going to be talking about the most important aspect of this card. How does he play as a defender? And honestly, this guy never put a foot wrong, all right? And what I would say about this right guard card is that he's not necessarily somebody that's going to stand out in game. Sometimes you get a center back and you notice him right away. This right guard card is more of a quiet beast. And what I mean by that is that he will do his job. And he will do his job perfectly. He will never put a foot wrong for you, but he does it quietly. He's quietly solid, and I really found that my defense was very hard to score on with this card in my team. So first, we're going to talk about his stand tackle at 88. And this is something I was kind of worried about because his aggression is fairly low at 77. However, his strength was 88, so I was wondering, was he going to feel kind of weak going into a challenge? And I think his stand tackle was very well-rounded. He's stocky in game, so that's number one. So he is good at winning those 50-50 challenges despite his low aggression. His stand tackle itself is very clean. And because he does have long legs, it's a very accurate, clean, strong tackle. What I will say, though, is that he won't feel like somebody like a Rio Ferdinand, like a Desailly, or even like a Blanc going into a challenge. Those guys, when they go into a challenge, they're bulldozing into the to the offensive player, and they're taking the ball away. This guy has more finesse to his game. So he's going to shield the ball from the opponent, maybe. He'll grab the ball with his long legs, but he won't necessarily bulldoze into the tackle, if that makes sense. His aggression, I didn't really notice letting him down defensively most of the time. There's only some instances where I did notice him notice his aggression letting him down, and that's really when I came against like a Lewandowski or a Ronaldo. But at the same time, that's why I placed the anchor chem style on him, and I feel like it did mitigate that problem. His interceptions at 88 is very nice. And I noticed his defensive awareness alongside his interceptions, both being 88, really played well together because he does have long legs. His defensive positioning is very nice, and he was always there to break a play. He was always there to put in the last-ditch tackle, and even though I didn't really notice him, he was always there when I needed him. And overall, I gotta give this guy's defending a 9 out of 10. Next, we are going to cover his physical, and I did cover some aspects of it when I did touch on his aggression. His strength at 88 is very nice. He is good at shielding the ball if that's what you need out of a center back. He's also good at really not getting bullied by opponents. Like I said, because his aggression is very mediocre, he's not going to be able to nudge people off the ball all the time. But at the same time, he's not going to get nudged off the ball either. So the best way to really use him is to stay with the opponent, look for the chance to tackle, put that tackle in, he's going to come away with the ball. His stamina at 87 means that if you do want to play him in a midfield position even, he could probably last all game. And his jumping at 80 was very nice. He's 6'2". He wins most headers. Overall, I got to give his physical an 8 out of 10. All right, guys, so what do I think about this card? I think this card is a great center back. If you do buy him, I think you won't be disappointed. He's a very, very reliable center back to have on your team. Is he worth 500K? I would say if you don't need the icon links, I would look elsewhere as far as center backs, as far as value for money. But if you do need the icon link, I think he's probably one of the best you can get at this price range. The thing that really keeps him from being an even better center back is, like I said, he does have decent aggression, but if it was higher, I think he would be more noticeable in game, and he would be really be able to be a vocal point or a focal point of your defending. But overall, he's going to be very nice defensively, and he won't let you down. You might be wondering how I'm doing the weekend league, by the way, and I've had another good day today. Yesterday I went 6-2. Today I've went 5-1, and overall we are now 14-6. So we started off 3-3. This is the third straight weekend league we've started off horribly. We started off tripping over our own feet, and now we're back in pole position to hit gold one. All we gotta do now is win 6 out of our last 10 games tomorrow to hit gold one. So hopefully we can do it. Let me know in the comment section down below, have you tried this Rijkaard card? What's your experiences with them? Let me know in the comment section down below, how are you doing in weekend league? Once again, don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next video. But until then, later.